Okay, hi. What's up? I'm just gonna check to see if that audio is working. Alright, that audio is working. Hey, so, what is this? Yes, hey, This is a game, and it's called Star Trek Online, and I've never played it before, but apparently it's good. So, hey, I'm gonna play it. This is gonna be interesting. It's gonna be my first impressions on this channel, so, exciting, I suppose. What else? This video almost didn't happen. I'm not gonna go into all the gory details, but, I got a new... Well, okay, this computer... I got a new keyboard, a mechanical keyboard, a really clicky one. That's really nice to use, but it's really loud, so I had to move back to my old one, which isn't quite as loud. And I... Let's just say I ran into trouble with that. Anyway, choose your species and... Oh, let's go back. What's back here? Oh, okay. Here we go. Regular play, create content... I don't know. New character. Alright, let's make a new character. Female 23C human. Female Andorian, Tellarite. Or Vulcan. Alright, we can be the original series... The original series Starfleet... Starfleet, which is a little bit better looking. Oh man, look at all these races. We got a Ferengi. We got other people. We got a Saurian. I don't even know what that is or that. I haven't watched a lot of Star Trek. I've watched like a couple episodes. I'd say I've watched about half a season of the original series and like one or two episodes of Deep Space Nine. So I've watched a little bit. It's decent. It's not my favorite science fiction series out there, but it's certainly got its merits. So yeah, that's it. I watched Star Trek at the wrong time. First off, it wasn't the 60s, and second off, I'd already watched Red Dwarf, so. Which just makes everything pale in comparison. I don't even know if that's the right term. But, alright. We got Romulans, which are... We got a Romulan and an alien. Okay. What do the male versions of these look like? Just alien. Just alien. Not... just alien. Not the... alright. We got Klingons. We got Gorns. Ooh, look at that guy. That's a guy. Got Lethians, Nausicaans, man, Alien versus Predator stuff, I assume. Male, an Orion, and an alien. Again, just alien. Okay. We should probably do, like, that, I'm gonna do that Nerd Cube thing. Alright. Do that. Why did I clear my throat just then? Was that for a joke? I don't know. My throat wasn't unclear before that. Shut up. So, let's do that Nerd Cube thing where he runs through all of them with sarcastically. Alright. We have Man with Huge Ego. Guy with the head with a headband. I don't know. A librarian. Spock. I don't know. A guy who put a little bit too much effort into his cosplay. Another a human. Fish. Human number 3. Armadillo head. I don't know. Giant eyebrows. Cracked face. Amphibian. A librarian, but slightly older. Another human. another human, a blue guy, another human, a human who's been a Smurf. That's it. Man who has been in a car accident, but only his forehead. Lizard. That person you've always considered playing in Skyrim, but never actually have. Ew. Alien versus Predator. Oh man. Guy who's dipped himself in blue paint and then glued stuff to his head. And finally, anti-eyebrows. You know, they're like anti-eyebrows. They go into your flesh instead of out of them. That's it. Let's be... I like the look of this guy. Do you want to be engineering, science, or tactical? I don't know. Sure. Saurian. Reptilian race from Saurian. Oh my god. Jeez. Alright. Reptilian race from Saurian. Saurians are intelligent and make excellent Starfleet officers. Saurians have a circulatory system with inherent redundancies to make them hard to kill. They are comfortable underwater. I feel like that's important. And can adapt well to rainforests or swampy climates. They're resistant to poisons and can breathe a variety of gases without ill effects. Saurians are renowned traders, and most of... Traders as in... You know what I mean. And most of their early interactions with other species were related to commerce. Saurian brandy is blah 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 prized throughout the Alpha of Alpha... I can talk. Alright. Accurate, aggressive, assault training, astrophysicist. Any minuses? Ah, crippling fire. Enhances... Minus 2.5% accuracy penalty inflicted from a critical hit with crippling fire. I don't care. I don't know what that means. Minus 25% threat generation. And... Oof. Alright, sure. This seems reasonable enough. Class info. Science or tactical? What does tact? Okay, hold on. Let's just read the TLDR. Engineering, survivability, support generators, enemy. Engineering officer can withstand most damage by improving the performance of their own personal shields while supporting his away team with power generators or by bottlenecking the enemy's advance with defensive minefields. The engineer's own combat effectiveness is improved by modifications to their firearms or support fire from fabricated turrets and drones. Science. Science officers protect their ship and crew from weakening or incapacitating the enemy over time, creating energy fields that damage or hinder, and healing their away team from such effects. The science officer has the greatest potential to quickly react to a chaotic combat situation through direct enemy holds, weakening an enemy's group combat strength resistance, or responding to enemy attack by quickly healing damage. I am recording, right? Yes, I am. Just needed to make sure of that. Now, the science officer's combat effectiveness depends on their versatility. And tactical. Combat damage, stealth recon, and squad tactics. The tactical officer can deliver damage in the widest variety of methods while supporting his away team by drawing off enemy threat or bolstering their combat effectiveness with tactics and squad commands. That seems like my kind of class. I'm a Starfleet... You know what? Do I want to be a fascist? Yes. Appearance. Oh, jeez, I don't know. Oh, man, do I want to be... do I want to be Deadpool? Man who was rolling around in the sea in, like, a pebbly sea and then, like... I don't know. God, I don't know. I could have war paint, or... I could have the residue from a skeleton man grabbing my face. And sort of leaving that sort of imprint that you sort of get when you, like, press too hard on skin and it sort of, like, makes it all weird. You know that happens, like, when you have, like, pressing your skin, it's, like, for a little while, like... For, like, 4 seconds afterwards is, like, this little, like, white mark. If you're white, I don't know. And you sort of get that effect. You know what I'm talking about? Maybe he just has, like, glow-in-the-dark paint on his face. let's go with that guy. And background. Ugh, okay. My captain's name will be, Sir Alistair... Allison. Alliston. Harriet Tubman. No. James Foreman. I don't even know who that is. Jan Michael Vincent. Jan Michael Vincent. How about that? How about, Erno. No. This will take me a long time. It takes me a long time to choose a character's name. Probably, if I were to have a child, I would spend less time choosing their name than it would take me to choose the name of my character in MMO. That's just how it works. Barry. Barrison. How about, How about Lionel Butterboy? How about, his first name is Alexander Vladimir Butterboy. There we go. Alexander Vladimir Butterboy. My ship name will be the USS... My ship name will be the USS... Saranara. No. Epimetheus. And my biography will be... He just sort of showed up. He simply faded into existence one day, and he has no memory of any prior. There we go. To this day, he has no idea who he is, who his parents are, and why he exists. And how he got his training. There we go. Engage. Oh, but we've known each other for so long. I didn't know you thought that. I don't know. We can just patching files. Loading training day. All right. Okay. All right. Alexander Vladimir Butterboy. Oh my god. Wow, look at this low res. We got a spaceship.
After I left Starfleet, I made it my life's work to reunite the Romulans with their Vulcan brothers.
Oh, man.
For many years, I lived among them and waged the campaign of peace. Live long. 21 years ago, the star of the Hova system went supernova and sent a wave of devastation across the quadrant. I promised to save the Remulan homeworld. I failed. The planets Romulus and Remus were destroyed.
Oh my god, they're actually called Romulus and Remus? Jesus.
My home, my friends.
That's gotta be a joke, right? No. Oh my god.
Time does not stop for one man.
I need to Google that. Are there actually alien planets called Romulus and Remus?
An opportunity to expand its territory. Jimpok, the Chancellor of the High Council, traded diplomacy for the tip of a blade. Only in battle, Jimpok says, is a Klingon truly Klingon. The Federation did its utmost to preserve its alliance
Klingon.
With the Klingons.
Like, you know, those, like, little seeds that have, like, Velcro stuff on them and, like, cling on to your clothes? That's what a Klingon is.
The Romulans want revenge for their lost world.
The year is 2258, 10 years after the Earth-Minbari War.
The Dominion is rebuilding its forces. Now the Borg have reappeared, and the Alpha Quadrant balances on the edge.
Oh no! Jakar! He's dead. I don't know. Wait, she's actually human.
The fate of the galaxy rests in your hands.
In my hands? I thought it would... I'm sure you say that to everyone. Welcome to Star Trek Online. Today is graduation day, and soon you will be embarking on your training cruise, where the bulk of your ship is manned by cadets by yourself. Why can't they be womaned by cadets like myself? Sexist. This tutorial will introduce you to the basic controls of Star Trek Online, including movement, combat, and interacting with characters and objects. Oh, good. Interacting with characters. I wish I had gotten that training in real life. Is there... Hold on. There's some sort of controls. Oh my god. Okay. I never could get the hang of controls in MMOs. Is there a first-person view? That's a no. Is there a way to get to the first-person view? Keep on camera type. Free camera. There's no option for a first-person view. Okay. So we've got this guy, this gentleman right here. So we're controlling. Yay, it looks pretty good. You know, this is 2008 quality game, which is quite good for like an MMO. I've played Lord of the Rings Online. That's like a 2002 quality game, like in terms of graphics. And ooh, I can look up. What's that? What is that? Some sort of shuttle? All right, I don't know. Hey, what up?
Finally, I was beginning to think you forgot what today was.
Tuesday.
Of course, I was first in line.
I think question that I asked her?
He wanted to thank you for helping him cram for the astrometrics final.
What is this backstory that I've been given? Okay, I need to change those controls. That is excruciating. Keybinds, there it is. Option run home, aim mode, X, C, at Z, H, Q, A, D, Q, E. Just switch those around. Oh, that does that anyway. Whoa! That's something. Is that good? Is that controls I want? I don't know. Who am I talking to now? Locate Razki. Razki? Like, Razko Lavos? Alright, talk to Cadet Razki.
There you are! I wanted to thank you for helping me pass that final.
Is that how my species talks?
And for all the other times you've helped me. I've always admired you. I hope Star Trek recognizes all you've done to lead our class.
He doesn't say your name! What kind of crappy game is this where they don't even say your name? Ugh! Alright. I guess that's just too much effort for the game designers to put in. I haven't received my assignment.
Good luck.
Yet.
Before you report to Lieutenant Farah and get your assignment, you should find Tavrel. She wanted to talk to you. She's just up the pathway.
Tavrel? All right. We gotta find a... Is that good control? So we gotta find Hey, you're not... What are they called? What are they called? What are they called? Oh man, what are... The ones who the Centauri have always been at war with. That's a very... That sort of thing name. Dang it, alright, fine.
Greetings.
Greetings! Roski said you had something to tell me.
It was good of you to encourage me to retake the linguistics final. I was willing to accept my original results, but you saw that I was not at my best that day. My score increased by 12.8% on the second attempt, well within my standard norms. Now I am qualified to serve as both a science officer and a communications officer.
Good for you.
Morik would like to see you as well. He is ahead of us on the path. Live long and prosper.
What are you, some kind of... Are you a Vulcan? I can't tell. All you Star Trek people look the same. Is it the ears? Is that how you tell someone's a Vulcan? I don't know. They're all rubber forehead aliens anyway. This way is the direction I'm going in. But seriously, Babylon 5 is better. Cadet Roski. No, more. Whatever. Oh man, what are you? What's this? I don't want 10. Okay, there we go. Okay, let's just take a look at you. You're a fish person, is the obvious answer. But, I like how I'm looking at you by facing away from you. Yep, he's a fish person. Can I just, like, get up all up in your face? Wait, hold on. Dang it, fine. Yo, what up?
There you are. Getting excited yet? Once we finish our training cruise,
oh my gosh, this
we'll
is a game for 7-year-olds.
Ensigns.
This is, I mean, it has
the
that kind of
is,
voice
Captain
acting.
Taggart hasn't named all of his senior staff yet. From what I heard, the advanced phaser training simulation is tripping people up.
Do you know why I'm playing this game today? I'm playing it because I watched an episode of, like, the co-optional podcast animated earlier today, and I was like, huh, hey, I should play that game. Apparently it's good. Oh my god, it's a cat person. Alright, Farah. More like feline. Am I right? Ha! Laugh at my jokes. Laugh at my jokes. Laugh at my jokes, slaves.
Good afternoon, cadet. What can I do for you?
Oh my gosh, look at me when I'm talking to you. Jeez, so rude. Is this where I get my training cruise assignment?
Yeah, let's see.
Oh no!
Interesting. Report to Captain Taggart. He's in the office behind me. You're going to have to ask him.
Okay, apparently there's a problem with that thing I skipped. They're here? It sounds like it was coming on through, like, the loudspeaker, which is really creepy. Because imagine, like, being in this universe and being like, whoa, what? Who's... Press F? What does that mean? What kind of MMO sort of stuff is going on here? Alright, F. Deck F. That's the button you press to get to it.
Come?
Alright. What up, forehead dude? Everyone in Star Trek is a forehead dude. Is there a way to hide the UI? Some way? Hide that. HUD. Hide HUD. Like a hide HUD button. Maybe tab or something. Hide HUD. Hide. Some sort of skill. Gameplay windows. Inventory is on. Skill. Here we go. Hide HUD. Ah. Alt F12. Okay, there we go. Fine.
Cadet.
Cadet, you asked to see me, sir.
I did. I've been following your progress here at the Academy. And I must say, I'm impressed.
Your voice actor was phoned in, wasn't he?
I'm just looking at your final test scores.
Oh, man.
But I don't see your results for the Advanced Phaser Training Program.
Huh. So now I have a choice. I'm going to choose the bottom choice, because obviously that's the choice I'm not supposed to choose.
I want everyone on my senior staff to run that program. And I want to see good results, no exceptions.
Did you say senior staff?
I did. Like I said, I've been following your career here at the Academy. If you complete that program, I can put you on my bridge. I'll ask my tactical officer to set it up.
I'd be glad to be in your bridge. I mean, I don't want to fall into the water or anything. You'll ask your tactical officer to set it up. Your tactical officer? Officer, sir? Officer, sir. 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 Officer, no, stop. Stop singing theme songs to better science fiction shows.
Another fine cadet like yourself. Her scores were almost as good as yours, but
Star Trek is okay, alright?
Blemishes. Still, I'm sure Cadet Flores will settle down and become a fine officer someday.
Okay, I'm gonna crap on Star Trek in this video a lot, but that's something I do, because that's the character that I play for you, you see. Because this is YouTube and this isn't me. Excuse me, I need to blow my nose. Okay. Alright. Another thing to my freaking thing. Chair, why don't you god. Alright. Alright. Who? We good? We Gucci fam? Alright, let's do this. Let's find exactly like yourself. Continue.
I'll tell Flores to meet you out in the quad.
Good.
Talk to her to start the phaser training, and I'll see you when you're finished. Phaser you're dismissed, training. Cadet.
Alright. Yes, sir. Did I just hail him? Hail him. What? Oh my gosh, is this like Watson from that old Sherlock Holmes? Oh, no. Well, I thought it was funny. I thought that's how it worked. We got Watson doors over here. Alright, You spin me right round, baby, right round, like a record, baby, right round, round, round. Alright. Oh, wait, hold on. Gotta run. Oh, there you are, Captain Taggart. Or, no, Flores, whatever.
I got the tactical officer spot, just what I wanted. Where'd you end up?
Captain Taggart says he wants me on the senior staff, but I have to pass advanced phaser training first.
You never did that? I thought you were Mr. Extra Credit. Everyone knows that Captain Taggart expects all his top people to pass that program.
I'm sure every single player in this universe is Mr. Extra Credit. Don't act like I'm special, because I'm new. Hey, people who have played this game, in the comment section, all 9 of you. Oh, well, like, one of you, probably. Maybe zero. If you... When you started playing this game, did you get these exact prompts? Because I want to know. I want to know how impersonal this game is. Alright, this... My filter is all loose and stuff. There we go.
Don't worry, you'll do fine. Come on, I'll take you to the holodeck and set it up.
The holodeck?
Seems
I ain't no holodeck girl.
On Captain
I ain't
Taggart's
no
ship.
Holodeck girl. Whoa! What? Ruh! I can like stealth roll. Is there like a crouching mode? Ooh. No, I'm gonna roll everywhere.
Have you seen the whales in San Francisco Bay? I never seem to spot them.
All right, the whale.
I sometimes forget that Boothby is a hologram. He seems like such a.
Come on, give me a chance to make a joke. Make jokes about your lines of dialogue before you say a new. All right, have you seen the whales in San Francisco Bay? Jesus, just shut up! All right. Ooh. Boom. Boom, baby.
Training program. All right. Now, I hope Holodeck 2 is your lucky holodeck.
All right.
Shoot stuff, don't die. Pretty basic, really.
Kind of tactics
tonight. It's standard stuff. The program runs a variation on Mako assault training. The last time I tried to give someone a little help, I ended up on academic probation for the rest of the year. Not saying I haven't learned a few tricks since then, though.
Ha ha! Don't make it easy. That'll. Well,
phasers
right.
Are in the lockers by the holodecks. You can grab one there.
Okay, good. Ain't no holodeck, girl.
Your tricorder will point you toward your nearest objective.
Oh, look! It's that thing that's in every. It's in that general direction. Over these particular 15 degrees of your field of vision. Oh no, wait, there's a thing up there. Okay, good. This it? No. This, then. No, what? You're giving me mixed messages here. Oh, here we go. Get the pistol, all right. Holodeck 2. Now whenever I sit here, your holodeck, I can't stop thinking about holodeck girl. Ain't no holodeck girl. Oh yeah, the holodecks, one of the most ridiculous things in Star Trek. Star Trek is a good show, I'm just crapping on it because I'm playing a game about it. See, look, alright.
In combat, right click on the target.
I think I got it. Yeah. Yo. You. Okay. Oh shoot. Oh heck. Oh man. Nice how I have these auto-homing phasers.
While in combat, certain actions are disabled. Once you drop out of combat, more detail about ground combat will become available.
Got it. Can I... Is there... Oh, rearrange HUD? Oh, man. Alright. I don't really care about that. But, hold on. Options... We got... Oh my gosh, that is not good. Rearrange HUD. I'm liking that that's an option. But is there some way to... Is there, like, a... Oh, target... target, okay. Oh my god, alright. Okay, there we go. Right. The sorry about this. Target self. Ooh. Okay. I got my inventory over here. But I'm liking rearrange HUD. That's right there. Can I just move that a little bit to the left? So it aligns with the center of my screen. There we go. Teague, held bars, many notifications, PvP missions, mini maps, most priority interact. You know what? I think this is all good. Alright, anything else? Gonna explore around. Fine.
You can holster and draw your weapon.
Feeling lucky, punk? Oh, okay. But is there... Oh, man. Okay, fine. This is gonna bother me. Attack! Attack! Attack target. Attack target. Attack target. Attack target. Attack target. Attack target. Nope, okay, I guess that's not a thing. Hello, Captain Target, Taggart, whatever. Oh.
First officer, way to go. Just a little jealous, I'll admit.
Apparently,
at least now you'll get to boss us all around like you've always wanted. Yes, sir, right away, sir. May I get you a Ractogino, sir?
Nice. Ha ha, very funny, Flores. I mean, very funny, cadet.
You'll do great. But we should head up to the shuttle bay. Everyone else is waiting there for the ceremonial send-off toast.
Oh boy. I like how the minimap is automatically the good minimap. The good
now
kind of minimap.
All cadets report to shuttle bay to prepare for departure.
Because this is the only good kind of minimap. Although I like the little mini map up here. Turbo lift to shuttle bay. Press F. Oh, server not responding. Got it.
Okay, there we go. All of the senior staff is waiting by the bar. I'm sure everyone's a bit nervous, this being our first real assignment and all. So, I'm expecting an inspiring speech out of you.
Something heartwarming. Make Tyrell cry. Alright, I'll make Tyrell cry.
Just determine the rest of our careers. No pressure. I'll meet you over there.
If you didn't see that, I punched my fist. My hand. Like that. That's the sound it makes. Alright. Local. Can I just close that? Thank you. I don't want chat. I'm like, I'm not playing an MMO to interact with other players, dang it. Alright. I should probably holster my weapon. We are the senior staff of the USS Epimetheus. Each and every one of us has trained for the task at hand, and we are ready. I have the utmost faith in you. You're the best the Academy has, and together we can do anything. All I ask is that we support one another. If we can work as a team, we can accomplish our goals. To Starfleet Academy, to the USS Epimetheus, to her crew! Oh my god.
All cadets,
okay,
F. Please board your shuttles.
Alright, to 2409, yeah! Alright, cadet. Yeah! Okay, I got one. What? Hey, what up, deck officer? Are you a character or what? Right here. There we go.
Are you ready to head to the ship?
I don't know. Am I? Can I drink some alcohol? Is this alcohol? Can I move that a little bit out of the way? There? I think that works. Right? Nope. No. Hold on. Gotta position it perfectly. T goes up there, interaction window goes down here. It's gotta be perfect, alright? Shut up. Now. Toast, nope, that's not perfect. see it has that desperately trying to be Rodina music in the background. John Robert Matz is better than you. Just deal with it. Alright, let's talk to Deck Officer.
Are you ready to head to the ship?
Sure. Whoa, look, it's the Golden Gate Bridge. I think. Even though it's red and not a gate. Oh man, it's camouflage. The reason that space station is covered with lights is camouflage, so it camouflages into the background of space. Oh, it's not that everyone's leaving their lights on in like their rooms. Although, actually, no. It is that everyone's leaving their lights on in their rooms. That's the way it works.
USS Vesta, first of her class.
They do that in order to a crew of 700 camouflage it against the background.
Phaser cannons,
except that those don't look like
quantum
things, but shut up.
Focus controller. I can't wait to captain one someday. But
I can't wait
ship.
To be captain.
Miranda class, 200 crew, 2 forward weapon mounts, 1 aft. Average speed, warp 5.0. She's a tough little ship, though. I think I like her.
Yeah. All right, the NCC
92502. We need to get to the bridge.
Yep. Are these ships randomly generated? I hope they are. I want them to be randomly generated, because that'd be really great. All right, Elisa Flores.
I'm going to check in and then head for the bridge. See you there.
Nice. Oh my gosh. Stop opening up the chat. Is enter chat? Because I need to unbind that. Oh, can I also enter? Means I've unbound it. There we go.
I'm going to check in and then head.
Good. Okay. Now, apparently, I need to head this way. Hey, what up, Lieutenant Brickers?
Name and position.
Cadet Alexander Vladimir Butterboy, acting first officer.
I have your record right here, sir. Welcome to the ship.
Where is the captain? Oh, captain's my
captain. Captain Taggart is waiting for you on the bridge. Use the turbo lift behind me. It will take you directly there.
Now on, you will address me as, oh, captain, my captain. Because I've seen those movies. Hey, what up, Taggart?
Welcome to the bridge, number one.
Your name sounds like a slur.
Early in my career, I served with a captain who called his first officer that. I always liked it. As my number one,
we are number
one. I expect
you
to ensure my orders are carried out, and to advise me on the best course of action in any situation. But first, we need to get out of dry dock, get clearance from control,
need to get into wet
and close
dock.
The shuttle bay doors, then disable the tractor moorings.
Yep. We need to get into wet dock and we need to disable the tractor moorings because, you know, we need to encourage tractor native Spanish things. I don't know where I'm going with that. I was gonna make a joke about, like, the... Shut up. Tavrel, get to...
Earth traffic control has cleared us to depart, sir.
Very good, number one.
Who is number one?
Shuttle bay doors are closed, sir.
Very good, number one.
All right, number one. Cadet. I'm still a cadet. First bridge officer. Earthly wars. Okay. The UI seems unnecessarily tiny, oddly. Where's my chair? Oh, that's my chair. Alright. That's chair. Oh yeah, now this is a Star Trek. This is a... we're trekking, Star Trekking across the universe. Now what? This way. I need a sense of direction in my life.
Potter, take us out. One quarter impulse.
Yes, Harry.
Just checking to see if you were paying attention, number one. Potter, take us out. Maximum thrusters.
Ah! Alright. Ooh.
To sit, right-click on the chair you wish to sit in.
What? Why is that, like, coming from loudspeakers? Also... why don't we make that numpad 0? Your boy haven't done... Whatever. Okay. IJ? Maybe? No. Oh, whatever. I don't care. Map key. M. Yes! Oh, man, that is a low-res map. Oof. That is... Whoa, that isn't good. I'm gonna be your right-hand man. Your left-hand man's over there. I was gonna gesture with my mouse, but alright. Gonna take away my only way to show emotion through this medium. Alright.
Cleared from dry dock, Captain.
Good. Let's start with something easy. Set course for Vulcan.
Vietnam!
Course lead in, sir.
Engage.
Engage. Don't M-gage. If you O-gage, you've gone too far. Center. Oh, okay.
Captain,
all right.
I am picking up a distress call from the SS Break-Even. Audio only.
Let's hear it, Tavrell.
This is the SS Break-Even. Our warp core is failing, and we are in need of assistance.
Let them know we're on our way. Potter, lay in a rendezvous course.
Altering course, sir. ETA 3 minutes.
Transporter room. Prepare to beam over survivors.
Sir. Sensors can't read anything in the vicinity of the break-even.
Communications are out as well.
Keep trying to hail them, Tavrell. Number right. One, let's discuss the situation.
Them. Hail them. That's me hailing. I don't know. Alright, let's discuss the situation.
You heard the distress call, number one. What do you think we should do? Absolutely not. We're the closest ship to the break-even.
So it's our duty to assist. Alright, how noble of you. It's strange. Hold on. I'm gonna ASMR this.
Strange that the transmission was audio only. A warp core emergency shouldn't affect communications.
Good. What do you advise?
Shields up, sir. Better safe than sorry.
Raising the shields does seem to be a reasonable precaution.
Yes, sir. It could be a trap.
I agree. Flores, raise shields.
Is this how you ASMR?
Number one, get down to the transporter room. You'll oversee the rescue effort from there.
Alright, let's just continue on our quest. Let's just continue on our quest. So go around. Where do we need to go? Listen to my mouth noises. My spit swishing around in my mouth. Sexy.
All right. That's quite enough of that. That's why I have a filter to stop that from happening. That's what happens when I take away the filter. Hashtag no filter. Are you? There's no voice acting here. Rock! The break even should be in range. Rock!
I'm getting some weird readings.
I want to make a joke.
I can't get a solid lock. There may be interference. Trying to compensate.
By a huge car.
This is a lot different than the training scenarios. Beaming
but very similar
now.
To the plane, to the...
Hang on!
Very similar
this
to the
vessel is
truck
now property
in scenarios.
Captain Kadek of the IKS Chot.
Nice. What? He looks so confused.
Stop! Security is reporting disruptive fire in the transporter room, and Klingon transporter signatures are showing up all over the ship. They're boarding us!
Klingon transporter signatures? It's gotta mean cursive and stuff like that. Alright.
You have the command codes to unlock an armory near your position. Arm yourself, and any security team members you find.
I can leg myself.
We still have weapons. I'll do what I can. For now, I need you to concentrate on getting those Klingons off my ship.
Well, of course, I can't get the Klingons off your ship. They're clinging on. I've made that joke before, haven't I? Or some variation on it. Alright, hey, what's up, Cadet Rusark? Simply Rusark. Enter the command code. Alright. I've got to go into this drama position and type slightly below the keypad. Alright. Oh man, look at this armory. Not as good as a legory. See, I've made that joke before. It doesn't work. Oh, okay, here. Here. Alright, this is this particular part, not anywhere else. Taking a rifle. Gotta H it up. What? What is this? Cardiopulmonary resistance. Oh, we have no CPR. Alright. I know CPR in real life, too. That's what the fun fact about. Palm strike. Not a beach strike, a palm strike. Stun beam setting. And, beam setting. And switch weapons. Oh. And holster draw weapon. Got it. Okay. H. That's a puny weapon. Come on. Well, why do they all get huge weapons and I just get freaking baby weapon? Ugh. Oh my god, I don't know. Hotkey for that. Q? No. What is the hotkey for that? Oh, it's Z. Okay, got it. Good. Alright, this is what I'm talking about. Alright. Well, why are you staying behind? Some kind of wimps? Lock and load, boys! Let's go on! Uh-oh. Hey, look, it's a gorilla dude, I think. I don't know. Oh no, he's Wilhelm Scrum. Screamed. Whatever. Oh no, the holodeck has leaked. Alright. Oh no, oh man, that's a really good, like, defense system against that sort of thing. That's kind of cool. Genius, in fact. I commend the creators of this game for coming up with such a good thing. Oh. What am I doing? I need to go that way. I need to go here. No, I need to stay. I need to be right here. Oh, she's gonna status. Okay. You. Got it. And now, where am I going? Right there! Is it this way? Is it over here?
You can do extra damage to enemies by flanking them. Try attacking your enemies on their side. Or enemy target spotted. Flanking damage detected. An item has dropped for you. Move towards the island and press F to loot it. Flanking damage detected.
I'm being flanked. Oh, what are you? All right. What's this? Some sort of pickup? I knew it.
You have recovered the hypo spray. You can use this to quickly heal any damage you may have suffered.
All right. Oh no, you're fine. Okay. Apparently, CPR is done with computers nowadays. Okay, so I need to get around that. But is there, maybe it's F. No, it isn't. This kind of video? That's a very good question. Okay, apparently I'm not supposed to head that way. I'm supposed to head that way. However, I do that. Supposed to head right here. This is exactly where I'm supposed to be, right here. So that's wrong. I feel like that's supposed to open, but I'm not sure. Head right for it. Okay. So I don't know what's going on. Do you? Maybe I'm just an idiot and I'm dumb. Nope, not that one. Not that one. Okay, I'm supposed to head this way. That right? Okay, V is scanned. Okay. Oh, shoot. Oh, man. Okay, that's good. That's good. I like that better. For this mode. Oi! Alright. So I'm supposed to head that way. But I can't. Well, I don't know! What? I don't know! What's going on? Oh, am I supposed to do something over there? I don't know. What? Am I supposed to talk to you? I'm supposed to talk? Your name is Security. I can't respect you. What's going on? I don't know. I seriously have no idea what's going on. What's happening right now? What? Anything? What is going on? What is it going on? Like a particular place on the map that it's marking? Don't seem to be. So wait. You're trying to tell me that my day in Brooklyn ain't okay, question mark. No. I don't care about what's new in season 12, just tell me what I'm supposed to do. I need a sense of direction. I need direction in my games until you've given me autonomy. You've given me the resources to be autonomous. The confidence. Am I supposed to go out there? Is that it? Is that it? Is that... Do I gotta push my way past here? gotta talk to this guy? Do I gotta do this? What? I don't know what you're asking of me, game. All right. Am I dumb? Is it me? Is it me? Tell me if it's me. All right. Maybe I'm dumb. Maybe I'm just dumb. Are you? What say you? What say you, dumb? Am I dumb? Dumb? Are you dumb? Ah, you dumb. All right. Ah. 1, 2, and 3 are highlighted. I don't. Oh, okay, no, that's what that is. Got it. Z is switch weapons. It's 4. I don't know. What is 4? I don't know. Oh, God. I don't know. Do I got anything in my inventory? I gotta put that around. I gotta press U. Put that there as well. Good. Gotta wait before using it. I just do that up. Do it. Traits, skills, traits, I got me some freaking, heck, I don't know, aggressive, covert, and creative. I don't know what I'm supposed to be doing, alright? I'm gonna press I and I'm gonna move this around. Alright, fine. Never mind. Oh, that's what it is. Alright. Got it. I got it. Now what? Now what do I gotta do? What, you? Who are you? Who are you and why are you over there? Can I see who you are? I don't know why I'm talking like I'm in Brooklyn. But hey! You disappearing on me? Alright, cadet security, what am I supposed to do? I press F. I don't press F. I'm supposed to be in there, according to that little thingy at the top of my screen, but what? What am I supposed to do? Am I supposed to look in there? There's a thing there. Ah, I don't know. I don't know. Should I just head back home? Just go home? Back to my day job? Working at a library? I don't know why we're so keen on libraries in this video. I don't know. They're the butt of many jokes. Okay, do I gotta go around? Do I gotta shoot you? Do I gotta shoot somebody else? Do I gotta not shoot you? Do I gotta not shoot somebody else? What's the big deal? What's the big idea? You? Oh, I know what I gotta do. I gotta do 6 on you. Gotta 6 this up. 60 time. You ain't got no blue stuff. I gotta do stuff. Ah, shoot. I didn't mean to do that. Move that. Do I gotta do this to you? What do I gotta do? What do I gotta do? I don't know. What do you want from me? What do you want from me? I'm serious, game. Alright. I'm super serial right now. I'm stuck. I don't know what to do. This is not explained well what I'm supposed to do. This is like Pokemon, right? Pokemon Y is one of the worst games I've ever played because it doesn't tell you what to do. There's nothing for you to do. You just get to a certain point. I just got to a certain point and there was nothing I could do. There was nothing I that was obvious to me, that was made obvious to me at that point of the game. And you need to make it obvious. If you're gonna make a game like that, you know, make it obvious what you can do. At least not... Even if it's not obvious what you're supposed to do, even if there's nothing you're supposed to do, at least make it obvious what you can do. And this isn't doing that right now. This isn't doing that for me right now. This isn't doing it. Alright, this is bad game design. I think. Maybe I'm just an idiot. Maybe I'm being an idiot right now, and I'm just dumb. But I'm gonna work on the assumption that I'm not. You, Cadet Security, what is up with all this stuff? Man. You... Apparently, I'm supposed to be right here. Alright, so I'm gonna be right here. And I'm just gonna stand here. F4 or numpad? No, F4 was the cycle camera length. F5, I don't know. Ugh. Is there something I can click? Objectives. Tutorial training crews. Well, you're not doing it very well, are you? Repel Klingon borders. Okay, am I supposed to make it to the center? Am I supposed to make it over here? Because I already made it over there, and I... Over here? Gotta go back. I gotta go here, because I can't go there. There's no way for me to go over there. There's some sort of F. I can do by pressing F. Some sort of... I don't know. See, I'm not sure. I'm not certain. And I don't know what's going on here. I gotta holster my weapon before I can talk. Am I supposed to talk to you? I can run faster without it holstered. No, that's not. That's not true. I can run exactly as fast. Who are you? Who are you again? I forgot who you were. You're Cadet Security. You have the same weird name as that other guy over there. If your last name is indeed Security. Which I assume it is. Because why wouldn't it be? Why would your name be Cadet Security if your name isn't Security? Do I gotta kill something? Do I gotta not kill something? Is it me? Is it you? Is it yourself? Is it somewhere? It's somewhere in here, is it? Is it that? Rack? I don't know. I really don't know, and I'm kind of freaking out that I don't know. I'm not sure. It's really not certain what I'm supposed to do, and I don't know what I'm supposed to do. This is like taking up 40% of the video so far. It's really messed up. Does it think that there's stuff to kill over here? Because there ain't. Sure ain't. Sure, I'm looking around. It's real shiny. I can see through the wall. But there ain't nothing here that I can do. How about this? Am I supposed to look at this? At this backwards text? Am I supposed to go through this door? Am I supposed to shoot it? I can't shoot it. Am I supposed to punch it? Punch it up. Gonna holster my gun. We gotta punch it. Punch it, punch, punch it, punch it, punch it. Punch. Punch you up. How do I punch you up? Nope, that ain't punched. Let's get some punched up. Why don't you punch up? And we'll punch up, and let's get some punched up personal space up in this place. there. It's across this line, right? Some sort of line here, some sort of diagonal line. And from here to here. Anything special about that line? From there to there? Do I gotta see? Well, it's... I don't know. Alright, Captain Security, what am I... Cadet Security, sorry about that. I miss... something. I don't know. Cadet Security, do you mind if I stand so close to you? Does that bother you? Are you gonna call HR? What? I don't know. Some sort of hints? Any hints that I'm supposed to do? Some sort of, is this? We got fuel available activity. No, I think. I don't know. What is that? Oh, I don't know. You, butter boy, 100 out of 100, what? What's that top thing? I don't know. See, I have no idea what I'm supposed to be doing, alright? It's apparently day number 5, or 6. I can't read that because I've taken off my glasses because my eye is being weird. It is day number 5. I can't read that. Is that 5 or 6? I don't know. Scan area. Let's scan the area. There's 0 anomalies. Well, there's quite a bit of an anomaly over here. And there's Hail Starfleet. Accept the Foundry EULA to play Foundry missions. Episodes. There's PVEQs, PVP. Duty officers, you're not in a fleet, we got some game menu, we got some help and support, help tips are on, we got character status, I look like this, Alexander Vladimir Butterboy, USS Epimetheus is pretty messed up right now because it's got this huge gaping hole in it. And I have no idea what to do. I'm just wandering around. How about you, Mr. Whatever your name is? Mr. Rack? Rack? What can I do for you, Rack? Why is your tail going through the floor? Do I gotta press C? C is crouch. That's nice. Do I gotta merge through you? Like... You're gonna call HR because I'm so close. And you gotta get stepped up. Personal space in this place. And we gonna make this good. And we gonna... Some decals over here. Not particularly well-designed decals. Don't even cut into the wallpaper at all. How do you tell if you can open a door or not? I don't know. There's no way to tell. Unless there is. Maybe it's on the left and you can... Nope, they're all on the left. My dog is over here. He's an enemy, so I can't revive him. I'm not gonna revive him. Alright, Cadet Security. I don't know what to do. Oh my gosh. How long have I been recording for? A while, I think. I don't know. Legit no idea what I'm supposed to be doing. This is weird. My dog. Hey, dog. Come up here. Oh. Not today, microphone. Just, hey, dog. Hey, come on up. Ah. Oh, you're getting heavy. we got you because you're not a very heavy-applying dog. Alright, you're gonna sit there on my lap while I make a video. That's cool. Okay. Alright. I have no idea what's going on. You gonna get up or what, Zoe? My dog's name is Zoe. I apologize to any Zoes in the audience. If your name is Zoe, then you're not a dog, probably. Or maybe you are. I don't know. Cadet Security. Your sort of halo effect doesn't quite surround you well enough. There's a little bit of a gap here and there. And I don't know what's going on. And I just want to go home. And to my family. You know, go back to that bar where we were toasting stuff. Remember that? Got this big zapper, that big like moth zapper thing that you have outside, sort of like. You got, Rack, what am I supposed to do, Rack? Mr. Rack, I'm gonna get down on your level. You need CPR. You're responsive, so no you don't, but I'm gonna perform CPR anyway with my transcorder or whatever that thing's called. I don't know. This is all such a blur. Am I even recording? I am. That made the game lag. Jeez. I don't know what's going on. And you know, I'm okay with that. No, I'm not okay with that, because this isn't very entertaining. This isn't very entertaining to watch, so I want to make it more entertaining to watch by making it better, by knowing what to do, and I don't know what to do. So, there's something I'm supposed to shoot. Something glitched in the wall. I'm going to log out and log back in, see if that fixes anything. Don't look at my password. ST.71.20170108A. Okay, I'm gonna beam up to my ship.
You can switch between two equipped weapons.
Is that fixed anything? I don't know. Does that help me at all? I don't think so, and I don't know what I'm doing. Wait, there was a thing out there that wasn't... Yeah, that was... Oh no, that's just me recovering. Fatigued, perhaps. Alright, Cadet Security, what is going on? What am I supposed to be doing? You look like you're aiming at this wall over here, but that's not something that you should be shooting at. So, apparently there are two enemies over there, both named Beck. So, let's go shoot them up, shall we? Beck was a singer, like a musician of some description. See, there we go. This is some good old-fashioned space fighting. I mean, not space fighting. That's Rodina's domain. Now I need to talk to Captain Taggart. Is this it? Is this all?
Number one, we're doing our best to cripple this Klingon Marauder, there but we I need go. Your help. Time to show off that Academy training.
Sometimes missions specialized to your career class are available.
Okay. Nice. Alright, now I gotta head this way. That way, and this way, and over here, and somewhere over there. Go through that door. See what's going on. You know what? Alright, I finally gotten past that weird obstacle where I couldn't see them. And now I got a turbo left to weapons. And now I can finally make jokes again. Alright. Shut up with your Klingon bull. And let's go. This is dirt. This is Earth now. And let's go on. You turn more of the floor into dirt. I don't even know how you did that. I'm kind of impressed. Maybe you could go down to our gardening center and be gardeners. I don't know. That's my phaser. No, that's my phaser. Breach the door. Some sort of alternate weapon mode I could be firing. There is indeed. And it does more damage. Alright, Beck. Are they all called Beck? You have a very odd name. Fairly odd name. That doesn't even do that much damage. Alright. What's your name? I don't know. Apparently you're not a person. I can't highlight you. I can with grab Xerath. I don't know what Xerath and why I'm supposed to be grabbing it. But hey, let's do my weapons stuff. Let's just look away while I'm doing this. Type in while looking away. That's always a good idea in Brooklyn. And let's press on this. Let's boost that up. Got some boost up. Let's boost this up. Make sure it's nice and nice. Boost it like it was a booster pack for us.
Number one, we've got pinned up here, and the Klingons could send a boarding party at any time.
All right, number six.
Back on the bridge.
Go see to the bridge.
All right, we need to get back on the bridge. Maybe I'm on a boat underneath the bridge, and so I need to get back onto it because I'm not supposed to be in a boat. Maybe I have seasickness. Maybe there's something going on in my life that doesn't allow me to be on boats, on ships, on bridges. Alright, warrior. Dishonorable. Warrior. Dumb. Dumb. Shut up. Stop your shut up. You shut your up. Shut up. Stop your warrioring. I like the homing aspect. I think that's a very interesting thing to do. Alert, condition red. Alright, we're communists now. I thought those sparks were a mission marker because that's how games work. Apparently I'm supposed to be heading over here. Oh, heal cadet. Let's heal you up. Resuscitate you like you were resussed. And we gotta heal up this cadet. We got a CPR up on you. Only has
incoming
about a
transmission from the clip.
This is Captain Kayak of the IKS Chalk.
You've caused me more pain than any other thing in human history has caused to anyone else.
You have no hope of finding us or defeating us. Your choice is simple. Surrender, or we will kill your captain and then destroy
I feel
your
like
ship.
That isn't really a ship.
Perhaps your captain will change your...
I feel like that's not really a
Order
choice.
Order your crew to surrender, Captain, or I will blow them out of the sky.
Ooh.
It's your choice, Captain.
Do you want these children to die?
Very well.
What are you, some kind of children murderer? I don't know.
Number one.
That wasn't a good joke. I take that back.
I'm now the captain of the ship.
Yeah, buddy! Alright! Okay!
Orders are to lock onto my combat and fire!
Oh, wait. Yeah, I'm captain! Oh. Peher Tochzach. That's not even a real phonologically accurate Klingon thing. But sure. Make him proud.
Target lock, Captain.
Why doesn't he speak? Why doesn't he talk? Fire into the jellyfish. The billowing jellyfish. Okay. Oh, whoa, it was like cloaked or something. Klingons.
Direct hit! Captains on all decks! Shields!
What a coincidence. That seems like panicking.
Shields are offline!
Why do you all talk with the same voice? Am I a racist for thinking you all talk with the same voice? Is that Klingon racist?
We've lost our signal. What now?
Well, we gotta just unlose their signal then. Gain it back. Gain it back, like my faith in humanity after playing this game will have to be gained. Nah, I'm kidding. This is an okay game. Do I need to fix this? I gotta talk to you.
We survived, but the captain, Captain Taggart knew what would happen, and he gave the order anyway. Ultimate sacrifice.
One talk faster.
He trusted you to take command.
Yeah, all shut up. Can do now, shut up about it.
Survive.
Aw, heck.
And remember.
Cool. Alright, I'm the captain now. Woohoo! Oh, fine. Do I have to be standing on the floor? Do I have to be not doing that? Okay, there we go. Aiming from my chair. 40-50 is the day that this takes place on. No, it isn't. Now it's 60 years in the future.
Bridge officers add abilities to your ship in space and accompany you on away missions on the ground.
All done.
Still running diagnostics, sir. Took us some time to get the systems back online.
Hailing the break-even now, Captain.
Right.
Oh, hello, Starfleet. No hard feelings, right? I had to send that distress signal. If I didn't, that crazy Klingon was going to blow my ship into space junk.
Space junk. That sounds like a...
Because Starfleet's always ready to help and all, could you help me repair my ship?
Am I recording? There we go. Okay. I keep needing to check that.
I'm grateful for all you've done to save my ship and cargo already. But the sooner I can get out of here, the sooner I'll be
able to pay deck. Alright, I'll see what I can do. I won't.
Decrease your ship speed by using Q.
Got it. Oh man, that's pretty nice. Okay, I gotta say, this is some pretty nice space control.
Helm, full stop. I've stopped us this time, sir, but from now on, you'll be responsible for adjusting.
Looks like she just needs 3 or 4 warp induction coils. We have plenty of those to spare.
Position yourself near the ship and press F to interact with it.
Beaming.
We'd help you if
thanks.
But I just don't see any profit in that, you know?
Oh, wow. Jeez, what are you? Some kind of... Oh, what? Yeah, you just gone? Why does it take me so long to turn around?
Well, looks like we're on our own. At least they said thank you, I guess. About that cloaked ship full of Klingons?
Zarva!
Almost done, Captain. Level 2 diagnostics shows that almost all of the plasma injectors are damaged beyond repair.
Do you have replacements?
Not enough. Plasma injectors are made to withstand...
Any ideas?
We're not the first ship the Klingons have hit here. There's wreckage all over this region.
Alright, fair enough.
Scan
I guess
the derelicts
they're an equal opportunities disabler. Alright. Are there still... Is there still a... Oh, right, they're cloaked, aren't they? Oh, man, this looks pretty nice. Pretty. Scan for parts. Just stand in one place.
Bingo! I found some suitable debris in the boneyard nearby.
What's his name, oh?
Destroy 3 of those nacelles, and we should get the
parts
we need. Oh,
that's some weird, like, patterns going through space.
Press the space bar to fire energy weapons.
Ha, the space bar.
Item has dropped for you. Move towards the item and press F to loot it.
Taking through scraps we've left behind.
Yeah, that guy's getting annoying.
Alright, let's turn around very slowly and then go forward. Well, this is interesting, isn't it? Any day now. I'd like to get that.
These plasma injectors will do the trick, sir.
Gorgeous technology. If typo... Oh, wait, sorry. Type R must be a typo.
3.7 liter flow put with shielded reservoirs and a drop flow induction coil.
That's good, Morty. But remember the Klingon who wants us dead? I need it to work fast.
You have your problems, I have mine. I'll need some time to get everything installed and run a level 1 diagnostic.
All right.
We don't want to blow up the moment we hit warp 1.
There, then that happened. You're gonna be Dr. House.
Zarva's dealing with the warp core.
Zarva's!
But until she's done, we're still stranded out here with no way to call for help. Oh, don't forget the cloaked Klingon battlecruiser. It's probably making repairs faster than we are.
Any chance we can determine what's jamming communications in this system?
Of course we can. We're the class of 2409.
Ha-ha!
Tevrel has been working with the engineers, and they've pinpointed the locations of several Klingon signal jammers. That's what blocked our communications during the
signal
ambush.
Signal jammers? I prefer signal jelliers, to be honest. You know,
satellites.
It's just... Or signal preservers.
We'll be able to get a call up Starfleet, then.
You know. Okay.
You must be within 10 kilometers.
Pew more than a church.
Long-range communications are operational, sir. Shall I send the distress signal?
Sure thing, bud.
That Klingon ship took some real damage. I'll bet she's leaking plasma all over the place.
Ew.
We might be able to use that to find them. Understood. I'd rather not die to Klingons on my first day. Got it. I can trace the plasma signature right to the source.
Finally, we have an advantage.
The plasma signature to navigation. It will show up on the map.
All right, and as I said when I wanted my sewing machine, as I took my sewing machine to an engineer to have it fixed, make it so.
It's pretty far out, sir. We should use the ship's full impulse power to reach it. This will temporarily take power from other systems, but vastly improve our speed. Once we drop out of full impulse, the power will return to other systems.
I know, you can't be in full impulse.
I can't be.
Shut up.
Swift.
Activate full impulse by clicking.
Come on. You know, you don't really want full impulse all the time. Sometimes you want to be sort of more thinky, you know, you gotta think a little bit more instead of just being impulsive. But, you know, that's a pun for another time. And ooh, that fell over. They've engaged the enemy. Well, no one's engaging the enemy on my watch. Why are we firing torpedoes? We're not ships. We're spacecrafts. Send a torpedo! Photon torpedo! Ah, photon torpedo. Back when photon was a super sci-fi word.
By clicking on the icon.
pressing Alt and 1.
Alt 1. Better on Alt right, am I right? I mean, no, I'm not. I mean, kind of. I don't know. Wait, what was I doing?
Your ship is outfitted with laser beam banks. These weapons have a 270-degree firing arc. This is the firing arc for the forward phaser banks. This is the firing arc for the rear phaser banks. Note that both the forward and rear phasers have an overlapping arc of fire on the sides of your ship.
Hey, we're putting in actual naval strategies. Yep, that's an actual strategy, maybe. So that's pretty good. So, fun fact.
Federation captains who prefer beam bank weapons favor the broadside technique and will often circle their target, keeping them within the broadside arc at all times.
That is a good strategy, actually, like if you're doing that sort of thing in real life. What's this? Okay, forward and rear. Alright, got it. Whoa, it shows like the freaking arc range of that thing. Ah, that's nice. Okay, so yeah. It's all good. All good in the hood. Actually, isn't there quite a few socioeconomic problems in the hood? Var Warship. Okay. I think I gotta zoom in a little bit. That's actually like pretty effective, which is weird because it suggested it to me. Now what?
Incoming transmission, sir. It is from Starfleet.
This is Captain Pollock of the USS Renown. Do you require assistance?
Yes, sir. We were ambushed by Klingon marauders.
Would have to be very bold to travel this far into Federation territory.
Actually, we're pretty Italian.
Where is Captain Taggart?
He was captured and taken to the Klingon ship. They killed him after he ordered us to fire on his position. We should have water on his position. Or maybe earth, air, something like that.
And did you follow his orders?
Yes, sir.
So, I take it you are in command now.
Yes, sir, I am.
Very well. We will escort your ship to Earth space dock.
All right. What about the Klingon who killed Captain Taggart, sir? Kadok is still out there.
And if he reveals his position, he will be dealt with accordingly.
Until then, with. You are to set a course for our position.
Now, come on, there only needs to be one dealer. You need to deal to him, maybe. I don't know. Come on. Have you ever played any card games? Have played poker? I haven't. But I assume that's how it works. Hey, look, an ally. Why don't we go there? Zero. That's zero? No? Okay. Oh! Hey, there we- Ooh-wee! Let's attack him! Oh, okay. Oh, hey, it's those Klingons! Boy, did I not expect that!
Your captain begged for his life before I killed him!
Alright, so this is very entertaining. But hey, I don't know. This is like some sort of weird thing. Isn't this piece feature on like Nerd Cube something? I don't know. Oh no, that was like the Sins of the Solar Empire Star Trek mod. I should probably get Sins of the Solar Empire. Not quite sure what it's about. Apparently it's good. I'm assuming that like other real-time strategy games, because apparently it's a really fun strategy, it'd be better enjoyed with other people.
My house will avenge me!
Ah! Death!
Space dock, but first we must inform the USS Kittimer that... One moment. My communications officer informs me that we are unable to contact the Kittimer. We will proceed to their coordinates to determine if they require assistance.
Okay.
And your ship will accompany us. I hereby grant you a field promotion. This will give you the proper authority
field
over
promotion.
Your crew and final decision-making ability for your
felt.
Ship until we reach Earth's space dock and report to Admiral Quinn.
Alright, Admiral Quinn. I get experience points, Expertus, Hyper Impulse Engines, MK1, Phaser Beam Array Mark 1, Control D, Phaser Split Beam Rifle Mark 1, Keyboard 1, and Zarva. Zarva! Species Bolian! Alright, oh man, my ears are hurting. Ugh. I don't normally wear headphones. I normally do speakers, but that's not really an option now, is it? Where am I going now? I'm gonna go to the ally dude guy over there. Wow, he's far away. No. Shift R, right? Oh. Exit to sector space. Oh, what the? What, I can't use that nor- What, you don't trust me to use that, but, like, the automatic stuff can do that? All I want?
Ships travel at warp speed between systems. Combat does not take place in sector space.
Got it. I mean, there's gonna be someone who breaks that rule, obviously, of course, because that's how rules works. Rules are meant to be broken, said an idiot once.
We're here, Captain. The USS Kittimer is dead ahead, and the Renown is beside us. Our orders are to make contact with the Kittimer and find out why they've not responded to our hails.
Alright, set a course for the Kittimer. Hail! Hail! Hail!
Yes, sir. I will require approximately 15 seconds to make the necessary adjustments.
Ah, Captain Bolon. Captain Taggart, what are you both doing here?
Not Captain Taggart, sir. I'm in command of the Epimetheus. Captain Volok ordered me to come with him to your location.
Always good to follow the orders of your superior officers.
Do you know what happened with your communications?
These cadets were the unfortunate victims of a Klingon ambush. Captain Taggart is dead, and the ship is under the command of this cadet. The Renown was escorting them back to our space dock. But when we could not raise the Kittimer, I deemed it imperative to alter our course and assess the situation.
They couldn't Captain raise the Kittimer, they had to put him status? Up for adoption. Captain Yim, what is your status?
I'm troubled by the anomalies in this system.
J.
And if they're
Yim.
Affecting long-range communications, then they're doubly a cause for concern. Let's do this by
doubly?
The numbers. We've already launched 9 probes. Now that they're active, we can do an in-depth scan of the anomalies.
All right.
With all 3 ships collecting data, we should be able to complete this quickly and formulate a course of action. The Renown has the largest science team. So
it's
I recommend
renowned.
We send our data there for analysis. Any questions?
Any questions?
You're quite confident for a cadet.
You remind me a bit of
myself
when
I was an ensign. Of course, I wasn't commanding a ship back then. Let's see how you perform before you start claiming that chair full time.
Ha 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 ha. USS Kittimer. What about the adult? Where's the adultimer? Shut up, me. Nice. It's kind of like FTL, but not as good. Speaking of which, I should probably play FTL on this series. It's a good game. Better than this one. So far. Wow, that is... Okay, here. That is pretty. Alright, I don't care what you say. That is beautiful. Dang, I need to take a screenshot. Alright. That's good. Good, there we go. Alright. Now what? The Pollux system? Hey look, it's Earth. Pollux, I'm more of a Mondrian type guy. But alright, the Pollux system. What's the map look like? Need to look on my keyboard to see where M is for some reason. Apparently I'm supposed to be going to that place behind me. It is at this moment behind me, right there, in fact. Huh, this map indicates two-dimensional thinking. You are up, anyway, down. Apparently I'm supposed to be heading that way, but oh hey, what is that? What are you? I'm in here. There we go. Scanning it up.
Reports indicate traces of gamma radiation.
Oh, what?
But there's something off in the readings.
Gamma radiation? It's not like that's everywhere in space all the time. All right. Fine, all right. Ah. I'm in the green thing. Do I press a button? The script to all MMOs. Go into the green thing,
Kittimer,
press a button.
Are you seeing the same gamma radiation levels that we are? I'm not sure that a normal scan will be enough. We might need to do a full multiphasic reading.
We saw the same issue. How can we improve our findings?
My chief science officer, Commander Davis, suggests that performing a reverse tachyon pulse wave scan will solve our sensor issue.
What are tachyons?
Perform your final scans and then report back.
Oh, those are like the time? Those are like time particles, aren't they? Fine. Perform your final scans and report back. Whoa, okay, that's pretty. I want to do that again. It's really... I like the bleakness of it. Wait, no, hold on. I'm a fan of that. That's good. That's good. Nice thing to have. Now I gotta go over here. And I gotta go up over here. And I gotta come to a complete stop. Keep your hands and arms inside the coaster till we come to a complete stop.
Picking up a transwarp signature. It's right on top of us, the board.
Hey, what's up? You want to get torpedoed? Some other crime. Torpedoed. Up, photon torpedoes them, and they're dead. I'm pretty good at this, I think. I don't know. No. Not in combat? Alright. Now I gotta go over there. Hey, look, there's allies over there. They attacking some. I don't know why I'm talking like that. I really should stop. Is what I would recommend. But hey, you know why I don't listen to no advice from no one. Yeah. Alright. There's an enemy something over there, something or other.
This is the emergency medical hologram aboard the USS Kittimer. I am requesting assistance from any Federation vessel in range. I've lost contact with the bridge. I am unable to contact Commander Davis for new instructions.
Give me a situation report.
The Kittimer is being overwhelmed by Borg boarding parties.
These Borg parties
are different than the ones in my history records. They seem disconnected somehow. They're strange, but still quite dangerous. I am an emergency medical hologram, not a miracle worker.
I don't know what I just asked, but apparently it's ticked you off.
The Borg were brutally efficient on the Kittimer. The emergency medical hologram may be in command simply because no one else is fit to do so.
Were they the Kittimer Rouge? That's the worst joke I've ever made, I'm sorry.
Their arrival cannot simply be a coincidence.
It's not even funny.
However, I hesitate to speculate without the full data from all of the probes.
All right.
I will send teams to aid the Kittimer. You will
have
to
finish
the
scans.
We need
to know the extent of the Borg presence here. You must also inform me if you or your crew are unable to continue.
The Borg evoke a strong emotional response that can rattle even trained Starfleet officers. A crew of cadets that have already survived
a Klingon attack may be unable to cope. I trust my crew will get the job done. I've linked the loader point on your map. Scan there to see what's up with the Kittimer, I think is what he said. I'm not quite sure. Is it over there? It's over there. What's up with the Kittimer? Alright, why the cloud go away? Let's speed up. Speed ourselves. No, not that. Don't torpedoize. Transmit some data. Or data. Or whatever, however you want to pronounce it.
We have your data, and our science team is analyzing it now.
Alright. One is my name, the other is not.
Have eliminated the Borg boarding parties on the Kittimer. Why do you ask?
Okay. No!
There is an 88.47.
What did I do?
We have your data, and our science team is analyzing it now.
We have your data. Pay $500 if you want to see it again.
Our tactical teams have... Oh.
There is an 88.47% chance that you will need my help.
Nice!
75 million gigaquads of computer memory.
Gigaquads?
Library of
that doesn't
of
even mean anything.
Command strategies.
Gigaquads?
I believe I can spare a few bits of processing power for you.
Gigaquads? Is that like four bits? Because then that's like an amount. I don't know. I can spare a few bits of processing power for you. Let's see what we can determine. Let's see what we can see. Borg transwarp signatures. You kidding the heck out of me? Fine. Speed up, speed down. Good, you're dead. You're dead too. Have fun dying. Being dead. Have fun being dead. I hear it's fun. You know? Going to a party where no one's still alive. Do 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 do. Why can't I attack you? I should be able to attack you. There we go. Engage the enemy. No, I've already made that joke. I can't make that joke again. It's against company policy to make a joke twice. The S-Narcissus company. The company I represent.
More Borg. I don't know if we're ready for this.
Oh no! What is up with the Borg and their, like, they do not make good looking spaceships. I'm still at 100% health and I'm like a newbie. Should tell you a lot about the state of their attacks. I don't know why I called it the Epimetheus. It seems like a pretty good name for a ship. So, I'm gonna circle around. I'm gonna circle it around. Oh no, I'm at 99% health. Ooh. Oh, shut up about your red alerts. We're at 98% health. We are in no danger. No danger whatsoever. Oh, what is that? Do I have to fight it?
Multiple Borg warp signatures.
Oh, it's a Stargate. Okay.
It's an invasion force.
Oh no, they're sending their balls.
We're outnumbered. There's no way we can.
Alright, we just gotta punch their balls. Just screw up their balls. Chew them up. Make them all chewed up. These balls are getting a bit testy. Taste my torpedoes, you Borg scum. You communism metaphors. Well, that was easy. Yeah, cool guys look straight at explosions.
Ew.
Voomph. In true Red Dwarf fashion, which is a better show than
Here
Star Trek.
Is the situation as we see it. All the right. Borg are using the Pollux system as a staging area for a larger invasion. Long-range
as
sensors
you see
are
it,
already
can
detecting
it be as you be it or as you de it? I'm gonna
the most likely
I'm making letter jokes
is the
up
Vega
in
system.
Here.
There is a civilian colony there, and if the Borg could take it by surprise, they would have large numbers of new drones at their disposal.
How large?
You must go to the Vega colony and warn them that the Borg are coming.
Vega, that's where vegans come from.
The Renown is better equipped to hold off further Borg attacks and assist the Kittimer. It is logical for us to remain here. We will delay the collective, but you must warn the colonists at Vega.
Okay. Right. Sure.
We have to make our way to Vega as soon as we can, Captain.
Hey, let's depart the system. This seems like a good place to leave off soonish enough. Unless this is gonna be like those super weird games that are like addicting and stuff, and like force you to be addicted to them. Oh, look at that! They're stuck with a bunch of Borgs. Oh well, look at that, the Borgs. Ha! Look at those losers who are stuck fighting stuff. Wow, that's bright. All right, I feel like this is a good place to leave off. I don't know if it actually is, but you know, can I like walk around my ship? I don't know. I'm gonna enable astrometrics. So I can turn this 3D plane into a big 2D plane. And let's disable astrometrics because that doesn't look nice. And I'm gonna do that. And I'm gonna take a screenshot because this game is really beautiful. And I'm gonna leave it off right there. So, ladies and gentlemen, and Borg. That was Star Trek Online. My name is Asnar Decius, and bye.